So this is the Hamilton Beach Good Thinking Iron. So we have a small daughter now. She's like almost a year old. And like, you know, we saw that, you know, the wire was hanging and she was trying to pull it. Obviously, she did not get down because it was like heavy. But still, right now, we need to start thinking of a lot of those cases. And if you think about it, almost everything today is like modernized, right? So I think our appliances should also be modern. And this one is one of the things that I feel is modern. And basically, that was my daughter. You know, it has a retractable cord, right? So you know that the cord is just hanging everywhere. You need to fold it and everything. But with the retractable cord, it's really nice. So I'm going to open this and show this to you. I'm unboxing it for the first time. I'm also going to do you later once we actually use it. And you can see this is the iron. Here, you can see it's inside the retractable cord. Right? There's also a warranty card and stuff like that inside. So yeah. Okay, so you can see this is the iron. You can see it has a self-clean button. It also has a, this is where you can fill the water. Right? And obviously it has a max area, so that you know how much water you should fill. Because if you overfill, then you know it might overflow. Right? This is the steam and this is the water sprinkle button. And this is obviously what you would expect in an iron. Min, max, settings, cotton, linen and stuff like that. Right? Okay. The nice thing I would say, self-clean and retractable is what makes it a modern iron. Right? And you can see I'm going to pull it. You can see here. By pressing this button, you pull it. Let me show you again. And you can see how this is a great technology. And you see it does not require power, right? So it's spring loaded and it does this retraction for you with the spring. So that is really nice. So it's not like it's going to cost you money. And you can very easily place this anywhere now without, you know, worrying about your baby, you know, pulling it or something. So let's say if you are putting it on an ironing table, even though you're out for just a second, you know, your baby won't be able to pull it and, you know, drop it on her shelf or something, which obviously need to be taken care of, right? Below, you can see there are holes for steam and water. So this is where all the steam and water will come in. And I think this is where the water will spray. So you have steam and water functionality here and here, here and here, right? Now I'm going to show you it in action. Also here you can see you can also control amount of steam that comes in, right? Zero steam, two more steam, right? You can control. So you have an option here as well. So you don't need to use the water steam functionality if you don't want to. Alright, so now I'm going to show it in action. Okay, so first I'm going to show you how to put water in this thing, right? So open this thing and you can see have something like this, right? And start filling the water in. Okay, so now obviously, right, you can fill it as much as you want up to the max level. I'm not filling it to the max because I don't want to do too much ironing. I don't want the water to just stay there, right, for a long time. So, for now I'm done this. Another thing that I would recommend you is, keep it farthest away from the cable, right? That way you don't pull too much, but also not too less. You can see what I've done is, I want you to note that I have not kept it completely close, right? I do want a little bit of a leeway, right? When I turn it or something, it works. Right now I kept it at minimum. So I'm going to keep it at minimum, right? Now I'm going to use this, you know, to show you. So I'm going to first of all let it heat a bit. Right? Because we don't want to waste too much of your time, so let it heat. Okay? And you can see it stands like this as well without any issues. Right? Now you can see it's like a nose pin. I don't want that. I want it to be a little bit in between maybe. So I'm keeping it here. Okay? I'm also going to increase it from minimum to cotton because, well, this is a cotton, right? Okay. So now let's start and let me just show you a cube quick thing. You can see this, let me show you from here. You can see there was like a water thing. You can see there are small drops here, right? This is water and now this is steam. Once it heats up, you can use the steam. I will show you once it heats up a bit. And I can definitely see the warm. You see that smoke? That was the storm. That was the steam. And now I can just use this ironing board to, you know, start ironing my clothes. So yeah. So basically you have all of these options, right? And once you are done, all you need to do is okay. So now it's my wife, she's doing ironing, she's definitely better at me than this. And yep. It is easy to handle. My wife is petite, so you know, she likes to make sure that she can handle stuff easily. And like, it designed well as well that you don't burn your hands by mistake. So it's like well designed as well. Also, if you notice the video, you will see that wire does not go below. The wire is at the top, right? There is very less chance of, you know, wire getting caught in the hot iron. So all of these are design decisions, which I think are really great here. So very happy with all of these things. And you can see here, now it is ready. So that's how we will continue to do all the clothes. Okay, it's very sturdy and, you know, little bit heavy, but it's like perfect for the size of an iron, in our opinion, right? We have other irons as well. The best thing that I love about this is the self-cleaning feature. It's new, so I cannot show you self-cleaning, but it would be pointless. But the retractable cord and the self-cleaning feature make it a very, very modern iron to use. Okay, thank you.